get out of this depression.
The hours I put in, door to door for nothing, peanuts. Telling what is in fact a very good set of brushes.
That's a goddamn territory, ain't it?
You just slammed the door in your face.
Yeah, it's a territory. There's no doubt about it. You know, we'd all be smarter bumming the roads. What do you say, Arthur?
Hard times, ain't it, Arthur?
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
I don't suppose you're doing too well either, huh, Arthur?
Not doing very well.
Hey, wake up, old buddy.
Oh. Oh, I'm doing very well. Very, very well indeedy.
Heading for the cuckoo house, are you, Arthur?
Me? No chance. I'll tell you guys something. Everybody who ever lived in the entire history of these here United States would want to be me if they knew what I felt like inside.
What's wrong, Arthur?
That's the trouble with you guys. You walk around with dirt and ash in your eyeballs.
Hey.
You just can't begin to see what a fantastic world it is we live in. Come on, get your goddamn chins up off the floor. It's beautiful. It is. Shining. The whole place is shining. Can't you see it? Don't you feel it?
Sounds like a crate of eggs to me.
Sliced bologna, more like it.
Yeah, it would to you, Ed, wouldn't it?
What do you mean?
Because you don't know the young lady in question, do you?
That's
impossible to explain. Not the sort of thing you can put into words.
Oh, yes, it is.
It isn't the paddle, it's not the canoe. It isn't the river or tide that all blue. It isn't the long dreams that bring joy to you. It's a girl. It's a girl. It isn't a problem that you always wander to. It isn't a mountain flower or the morning dew. It isn't the loneliness that brings love to you. It's a girl that makes you happy and it's a girl that makes you blue. You are burned out them. What a lonely world would be without them. It isn't the song words, the song that they sing. It isn't the sunshine that makes you like rain. So what is this magic that makes all the thing? It's a girl. It's a girl.
Skirt, Arthur.
You lay her in the back seat?
She got big tits.
Everything I've ever dreamed of, hoped for, or longed for. Everything deep inside me. You're in my heart. She's everything.
Hi.
This is Bob Fitch.
Huh? I am
Bob Fitch.
Well, the real Bob Fitch, please stand up. This is Bob Fitch, okay?
This is Bob Fitch.
Stars, hell's a-poppin' and Annie and everything, and I know him.
Stars are major stage and
I know this guy. Okay? This is a real nice guy.
Silver.
Well, that's good, right?
Silver.
A little closer, maybe.
Color, you see?
Okay.
Okay.
The copper goes to the right.
See if you can see. No, you can see there are three coppers there. Can you look? You have to be a little higher looking down. You're too horizontal.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, we have the three coppers, and we have the three silvers. But you see, these are like members of my family, because while we have coppers here, silver's there. You see, my boys and my girls, they like to get together all on one side, huh?
That is amazing.
It is amazing. Now I'll show you why. They are very much like my children. You see, the copper, that is like the girls, you see? One girl. And we put here a silver, that is one boy. We have here a copper, that is two girls, you see? And now we have another silver here, that is like the second boy. We have a final girl, you see, there, and over here we have the three boys, you see. Now, you probably don't think it's such a great trick if I go 1, 2, 3 and take the three boys out separate from the others.
Right.
But I didn't do this trick. My kids did, because they like to separate.
Suck it, Blue!
The
coins have changed places.
That's right.
I can't believe it.
Now I show you something wonderful.
I'll milk on my coins when I get home.
You see? And make what? A video tape machine.
Yes, I'm going to build
one. The copper is there. You see, this marks what is in this hand.
Yes.
This marks what's in this hand, you see? But if I do this, you see what?
I've changed places.
Yeah, nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. No, see, you are paying attention.
I know.
You see, it's all in your mind. Now, the copper are here.
Yes.
The silver are there. Now, in fact, if I switch the copper there and the silver there, you see, they did not switch before. But like my children, when you say a magic word like please, the silver, you see, is there, and the copper is now over there.
Holy tuna fish sandwiches! That's incredible!
What do you think, eh?
I love it. It's very nice.
Okay, now we have a silver there, and we have a copper here. Watch fast. Hey! Silver!
Oh, fantastic!
Over here.
Oh, yeah, incredible! We have three copper here.
Yeah.
And three silver here.
Yeah, yeah.
You can see them? I close my hands. Now we have the three silver here and the three copper over here.
Terrific.
Incredible.
Yes.
Now I make them go back.
Okay.
Watch closely. The three silver here, the three copper here. Close my hand here like this. Copper here and the three silver here. Let's do it one more time. The three silver here and the three copper here. Amazing. We have two more hands here. Okay, now, we have three silver here. They vanished. Look, they're gone. We have three copper here. Three and the four and the six all together. Fantastic. Okay.
How's your trick?
Let's play that guy. I gotta see that.
Here, the most amazing thing, eh? We have here copper. We have here silver. Eh? Three copper, three silver.
I'll take them out of here.
All right, now watch what happens. Silver, copper. Now both together, go.
What?
You have to cut. Voila! They have changed places, huh? Now I show you something else. I count to three, and you will see the impossible thing happen. Ready? One, two, three. Voila!
Let's see how that works. Cards out like this. I will pass my hand over them. Watch. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, should I cut now?
We'll do it all right. I will try it again.
Okay.
Okay, when my hand reaches here, all the cards will change. Watch. 1, 2, 3.
Fantastic. Yes.
It changed. Upside down. They come right side up.
Wait a minute. I only like coin tricks. You see?
You did something amazing. You made the cards vanish and you put coins in its place.
I know. I didn't hold anything out. I
changed myself from a handsome, elegant older man into a rather sexy, swarthy, dark man.
I have changed. Look, my arms are smaller, my head is smaller, and completely small. Now change back.
Look, that's good.
Oh, Paris in the winter. Who are the people who are on the bill?
Three.
and John Keith. Now,
Harvey, excuse me.
Levent, when I discovered him, was in a high school doing magic on stage. I took one look at him and I saw a Vegas act. And the kid is 16.
He's 17 now?
17 now. When I met him, he was 14. He had two pupil kids. Now he's got a six.
BFD, Frank.
Okay.
He is a Vegas act, and you'll see what I mean. Let me introduce and bring him on with a nice applause, Mr. Levent.
Today, ladies and gentlemen, instead of an entertainment.
to tell you a story. This story takes place in the Old West. It involves cowboys and Indians. It takes place in the land of the rising sun. It involves an Indian chief named Running Water. He had two daughters, one hot and one cold. He wanted a third kid, but his wife had to force it. That's okay. Kid turned out to be a drip anyway. Running Water was the chief of his tribe. All the Indians in their village lived in teepees. Running Water's wife owned land in the mountains. She had two of them. She had the worst case of arthritis you've ever seen. Running Water's wife was named Running Mouth. Now, our story involves a general in the U.S. Army who one day decided that he would gain fame and fortune by taking Running Water's peaceful tribe to war. Running Water's tribe fought valiantly with their bows and arrows against the cowboys and eventually defeated them. They sat down and they... Hold on, this takes just a little while, folks. They sat down and they smoked the peace pipe. They also buried the hatchet. And so, all was at peace again in our Indian nation. However, one day, a strange man came to visit. Hold on, this takes just a little longer than I thought. A strange man, a lot like me, came to visit Running Water. The strange man was, hold on just a moment, this strange man was wearing a bow tie. You're not impressed. He was wearing a mustache. He had a ribbon in his hair. Anyway, this strange man tried to blame the war. It's not that funny. This strange man tried to blame the war on Running Water. Running Water realized that... Hold on, we're not through with the figures yet. Running Water, one more time. Running Water realized that he had been framed. The general hadn't been on the square with him. And so they took Running Water back east to stand trial before a jury. Here is where our story takes a strange twist. What happened was, Running Water was sentenced to be hung by the neck until dead. And here is where the good part of our story comes. Because as Running Water came up to the scaffolding, he realized that there was no rope. And here's the happy ending. Because as everyone realizes, when there's no rope, there's no noose. And everyone knows that no noose is good news. Thank you. Okay, everybody, now for the talent part of our show. I am about to perform some amazing feats of juggling. Yay! Wait, you're not impressed. Watch closely, too. Two hands. Okay, I know. Two balls. Hold on, just a moment. Two, juggling.
I got four.
No. Juggling. Three, I will get three.
Oh.
Okay. One, two. 3 days ago, I was doing this at someone's home, and what happened? No, I know, you're all expecting, so, juggling! Yay! I never said I was a very good juggler. Okay, could somebody please give me that one? Watch closely, everybody, you've all seen me juggle one ball. You've all seen me juggle two balls. You've all seen me juggle three. How many of you would like to see four? No. Hold on just a moment. The lady said, what was that number again?
Five.
No, don't mess me up. Don't
come on, shall we?
Hold on. Okay. How many? struggle now. Okay, okay. You asked for it, you got it. The hard stuff now. Gloves. Watch closely. One club.
Here we go.
One ball. And, another. Two balls.
Another.
One club. Actually, for male juggers only, it's four balls, one club. But
here we go.
You can't do that. Two clubs, one ball on the floor. Two clubs, one ball.
No.
Okay. Now we get to the hard stuff now. Three clubs. Watch close now.
Just shifting.
What? Oh, by the way, did you know I made these myself? What? Yes, I really did. I made them myself. It's really true. I made them myself. One! Oh, did you know you can do other things with them besides juggle? One! For instance, you can do impressions, such as Martians. Earthling, take me to your leader. Okay. One! Oh, you can do binoculars. Enemy aircraft coming in, fire all guns. I juggle something even more dangerous. Mr. Simkentley, what do I juggle?
Torres, stainless Books. Steel, razor sharp.
She's on next.
Hatchets.
Better than that!
Okay, electric power saws.
Better than that!
Three Volkswagens.
Better than that!
Two elephants and a donkey.
Better than that!
Oh, no.
Yes!
Three. Stainless steel, razor sharp, rubber chicken.
What? Okay.
Chicken juggling is against the law in this country.
I know. This is a really foul act. Juggling chickens. Juggling chickens is not everything it's cracked up to be. Get the yolks
first and catch up.
Before I bring on the next act,
two vagrants up.
I would like to ask the people in the audience one question. Are you having a good time this evening? Okay. Having a good time this evening. There is a box at the door with a slot. Please deposit any donation of your choice for the entertainment and the cleanup crew, which we are the cleanup. We sweep up, we clean up, we do all that. Full donation, 50 cents, a dollar, it doesn't matter. Okay? That's all I wanted to know.
As we make it
it appear, we can make it vanish just by placing it right here. I have a piggy bank in my leg. I just push it right in and I store all my silver dollars there. Why go to the bank? If I take it and I fold it over and I get some magic dust out of my pocket and I throw it on there, it completely vanishes. I'd like to open. That wasn't really an open. It's just a little nonsense that I do. I'd like to open with. Let me take this out of here because I'm not going to do it. With a rope trick. One of the nice things about magic is that you, at least that I find, is you try to be as versatile as possible, not just dealing with cards and coins, but with other objects, objects that people see every day. This is an old piece of rope, and in a few seconds I'm going to cut this story. One of the things I like about rope is it doesn't take that much room up. I can get 50 feet of rope and do a 30-minute act, 40-minute act. I get paid hundreds of dollars. Can't believe that lie, I'll say it's swampland in Jersey. She's cheap, right? That's the way she looks. Now, let me just show you some of the things that I can do with rope. For instance, I can tie a rope just like that. Did I do it? No, I didn't. This is a short rope that I borrowed. One, two, three.
He's loafing.